So you've just published your video on YouTube and you want to track it, and you can see that through real-time views. But what about the most important metric on YouTube? What about watch time? Can you track that as soon as your video goes live? Let's investigate.
vidIQ.com.
So then, 2.5 hours ago, I launched this video, and when I visit the Creator Studio Beta dashboard, we can see how many views we've got in the first 2.5 hours, but in terms of watch time, we have zippo. If I try and dig deeper into the analytics by going to videos, clicking on that video, and then going to the analytics, again, it will show me the velocity of my video in the first 2.5 hours, which is fantastic. But as it comes to watch time, yeah, there's still nothing to click there. But here's something a little weird and interesting. If I click on reach viewers, again it shows me the views, no impressions yet, but in the impressions to watch time funnel, it already has watch time analytics telling me that I have 1,700 minutes watched on 800 views, extrapolating an average view duration of 2 minutes, 60%, which is rather fantastic. But don't go anywhere just yet, because we've got another trick up our sleeves. Hello, welcome to all of you watching right now and all of you in the vidIQ community. My name is Rob. If this is your first time here in these glorious YouTube surroundings, we are the YouTube tool and channel that aims to help you get more views in less time by educating you on your YouTube journey. Now, we know as video creators ourselves that you want all of the analytics all of the time right up to date, but for some weird reason, the anomaly of YouTube watch time is delayed for 48 hours usually, at least in the old classic studio analytics. So I've just shown you how you can find out your real-time analytics on a video as soon as it's published in the Creator Studio Beta, but you can go even more granular than that. Take a look at this. Your port of call is the Creator Studio mobile application. If you go to your videos and find the video that you've just published, and then go to analytics, it will tell you that there is no watch time to see. If I tap on watch time, there is essentially no data. However, what you can do is tap on the time frame at the very top here, then tap on 60 minutes, and it shows you the real-time watch time for that video, even though it says there is no data available. You can also go to the last 48 hours, and it will show you the real-time there as well. So even though YouTube is kind of lying in the foreground, if you dive into the background of these analytics, you can get these specific bits of data. And one more thing, you can go even more granular than this. If you do a pinch to zoom, I can now see the real-time stats for the last 20 minutes, if I really wanted to do that. Just one more thing to mention, once the video has been live for 3 hours, you can return to the Creator Studio Beta, take a look at the dashboard screen, and you'll have that video snapshot, which now does tell you your watch time for the video. But if you want to follow watch time immediately once the video has been published, you've got two strategies. I hope you found them useful. We love finding cool little YouTube hacks, and we've got a video right here on the top 10 that we found. And if you want to find out more about general YouTube news, tips and tricks, we've got a playlist down here. We'll see you on either of those videos right now. Enjoy the rest of your video making day.